Okay, class. For homework tonight, do some research about your countries for your social studies project. And don't forget that high school applications are due this week.
Book of Ward. High school applications are due this week, so I might as well check it out.
Mary Ward is a self-directed learning center that is part of the Toronto Catholic District School Board. The school aims to teach its students the value of self-direction and time management. They are able to achieve this through three very important elements: the structure, the unit guides, and the teacher advisor. These elements have proven to be very effective in preparing students for life after high school. Structure. Mary Ward is not a regular high school. The school does not have a structured timetable, but instead allows students to create their own daily schedule with the courses they take. Their days are planned in an agenda every morning before school starts. The agenda is instrumental to the success of a Mary Ward student, so one must treat it with extra care. With students in charge of their own school day, there are no traditional classrooms where students go to learn. Instead, there are resource areas for each subject throughout the school, providing students with a quiet working environment. Teachers spend most of their time in one-on-one consultations with students. They also offer seminars based on specific topics in the unit guide. This is the Mary Ward equivalent of a traditional class.
Ms. Albert describes, seminars are extremely important at Mary
Ward because this is the opportunity that you have to learn from us. Seminars are kind of like little lectures, and we are very lucky in the math department because we have the technology available here in order to create podcasts of our seminar lectures. So as soon as you learn or you come to the seminars, you can go home and access taped versions on the internet or through YouTube of our seminar videos. The reason why we do that in the math department is we really acknowledge the fact that not everyone is going to learn at the same pace and not going to be able to absorb the information right away. So you have the opportunity to go home, watch the video as many times as you need to, and before you can start your homework or your unit work, and then you can come back the next day and ask the teacher for clarification. So seminars are mandatory in the math department as well as many other departments, and if you are going to do well here, attendance is a must.
Most courses offer these seminars taught by teachers.
All Mary Ward teachers are also teacher advisors. Each student is assigned a teacher advisor to help them work through the self-directed system to their full potential. Self-direction is the essential element to Mary Ward. There is a myth that Mary Ward is a school of independence, but being independent is different from self-directed. At Mary Ward, support is in abundance. For example, you have teachers to help you work through your courses. You have your teacher advisors that help you stay on track, stay focused, and set goals throughout the year. Without this support, you may find it difficult to finish the unit guides, which is also a key component of Mary Ward. Unit guides. Unit guides, or learning guides, are what the students work on throughout the school year. A unit guide is a series of assignments compiled in a learning package consisting of readings, study questions, seminars, and at the end of some units, tests. In order for students to effectively complete their units, they must come in contact with their teachers for guidance and assistance. Students schedule these consultations according to their teachers' floor schedules, which are provided at the beginning of the year, showing them when their teachers are available. At the completion of a unit, the student submits it to the teacher and moves on to the next unit. Students complete 18 units per course, with the 18th typically being an exam, final assignment, or portfolio. In order to write tests, students receive a notification from their teachers with an authorization number. Students then fill out a test authorization slip with a number and head into the test center to write the test.
Ms. Saran explains, units are generated in a unit guide format,
and they include all of the activities, expectations, and requirements in order to finish a given unit. They tend to vary between different subject areas solely because of the subject content. So we have very different expectations in the biology courses from the English courses. The teachers use Ontario curriculum in order to design unit guides. They have specific activities that they develop, whether it be readings or online tutorials, research, or other educational tasks that they implement in order to get students to practice their learning. Students are generally provided with an assignment in order to show student learning as well in the unit guides. There are 18 units per course, and the deadlines for these units are prescribed in the agenda book, but these deadlines can be used in order to plan for successful course completion. We also have a Catholic school, and our Catholic school motto is "Because we believe." So teachers implement and embed the Catholic graduate expectations in the unit guides. Being a former student at Mary Ward, I have seen both sides of the spectrum. So I have seen doing units as well as creating units. I can say that both activities have their fair share of challenges, but are both great learning experiences.
Teacher advisors. Teacher advisors, often referred to as TAs, are the backbone of Mary Ward's unique program. The teaching staff have duties as both teachers and teacher advisors. The duties of a TA are to check the progress of their advisees, give them guidance and support throughout the year, and to have a caring adult to talk to about their academic concerns, but also about personal issues and life challenges. The TA interview is a very crucial activity in the duties of the teacher advisor. TAs are given 1 hour a day to complete TA interviews in order for the Mary Ward system to fully function. Each student gets interviewed every 2 weeks. The TA interview is a progress report between the student and teacher in which they both discuss what academic progress has occurred over the past 2 weeks, and set goals for the coming week, and develop plans for how the student is going to complete these goals. But in order for this process to function at its full potential, the student and teacher advisor must have a healthy, honest relationship.
Mr. Wong has this to say about TAs. So TA basically stands for teacher advisor.
So every student that comes into our school is assigned a teacher advisor. A teacher advisor is basically a guide or a mentor for that student in our school. In our school, students have a lot of freedom, so as teacher advisors, we're there to guide them, to make sure that, to keep them in check so that they stay on track with their courses. Certain responsibilities that we have are to have interviews with the students every 2 weeks to make goals, to set out a plan. Students are having trouble with courses, having troubles with not even certain teachers, they can come to the teacher advisor and talk to us about, you know, what kind of help we can give them, and just any advice. So we're basically there for the students through 4 years, because a student will move up with that teacher advisor for all 4 years, and you really get to know a student over that time. Essentially, we're almost like a parent at school for them, if you want to put it that way.
Teacher advisors play many important roles. They are mentors, advocates, motivators, consultants, planners, listeners, career advisors, and friends. Life outside the system. When students are not focused on their schoolwork, there are many extracurricular activities available to take their minds off the stresses of high school. There are various sports teams such as basketball, volleyball, soccer, rugby, flag football, field hockey, softball, dragon boat, swimming, and many more.
Miss Weathers, the coach of the basketball team, says, "One of the most exciting aspects of this
is our extracurriculars and sports teams. Being a former Wolverine myself, one of the first things I was excited to do when I came on staff at Mary Ward was to become a coach. There's a lot of exciting opportunities offered here through various sports teams and different clubs after school and during school. One of the things that it really helps as a teacher from a teaching standpoint is that students aren't necessarily missing out on your typical fifth period class, and that allows them to be able to leave school for games and practices, etc., and still be able to catch up on work. So that makes you Mary Ward very unique when it comes to athletics and extracurriculars.
If a student is not particularly interested in sports, there are various clubs available, like Gender Justice, ESP, Student Council, or even joining the annual plays and musicals put on by the drama department. There are many things a student can do in Mary Ward to alleviate the stresses that come with being a teenager.
Mr. DeMore and Mrs. Davies, the chaplains of the school, say, "What is great about Mary Ward is that it is
also a community of faith. And here at Mary Ward, we believe strongly that it's not just about faith, but it's about putting faith into action. We try to live out that example in everything that we do."
Yeah, the beauty about Mary Ward and Catholic schools within the TCDSB is that you're not just getting an education that's founded, you know, in the curriculum, but it's also founded in faith, and it's
focusing on spiritual growth and spiritual development of each individual.
Yeah, so it's a pretty special place, and we're there to make sure that that you feel welcome in that community.
So hopefully that answers all your questions about chaplaincy, and all the best.
Our doors are open.
At Mary Ward, the future is truly in the students' hands. They are turning a new page in their lives and writing a new chapter. Life is an open book, and at Mary Ward, the staff diligently works to help each student write that chapter to their full potential. Once you enter the doors of the school, the story is what you decide to make of it.
Because at Mary Ward, you are not independent. You are self-directed. Wow, this seems like an interesting school. I think I know what high school I'm going to be attending next year.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone. But when I see you hanging about with anyone, it's not unusual to see me cry. I wanna die. It's not unusual to go out at any time. But when I see you out and about, it's such a crime. If you should ever wanna be loved by anyone, it's not unusual, it happens every day. No matter what you say,